for having providing me such an opportunity to address the valedictory function of NAIOP Navaratna at the All Kerala CA Conference, which is being organized, jointly organized by the 9 branches of South Indian Regional Council of ICA in Kerala. And it has started from 20th November and it is being concluded by 5:30 p.m. today. See, the Honorable Sri CA Chartered Accountant Sri Babu Abraham Kallivayari, the Central Council member of ICA, CA Jomon K. George, past chairman and member SIR of and Ernakulam branch of ICA, was very eagerly listening to the extemporaneous speech by, eloquent speech by Girish Ahuja Ji and other dignitaries, other office bearers of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the other dear delegates. I wishing you all the success for having this wonderful conference of Navaratna conference. And its dual meaning is very clear. Navaratna means it is 9 days of continuous conference which has started from 16 November and ending it today. And also the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, the is also having 9 branches in Kerala. So all the 9 branches in Kerala delegates are participating in this conference. And a conference of 9 days. So the nomenclature of the conference which you have selected is absolutely interesting to have this Navaratna conference. And we congratulate all participants and the chief speakers and other dignitaries of this conference. First of all, I would like to say that we are always discussing about the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India Act, because it is a statutory body incorporated by an act of parliament. That means ICA, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, is one of the creature, or it is one of the baby of the Indian parliament in the year 1949. And subsequent to this 70 years of our experience, 70 years experience, now throughout the country we are having around 3 lakhs of chartered accountants in India. And it has become one of the significant body. And it is one of the accountable institution by which almost all the government establishments, semi-governmental establishments, private entrepreneurs, all the corporate bodies are being now depending on the chartered accountants. I would like to say one point, because we are in a parliamentary system of democracy. In a parliamentary system of democracy, always the government is accountable to the people of India. The governments or the executive is accountable to the people of India through the parliamentary mechanism or through the legislative mechanism. And I would like to say that the chartered accountants in India is playing a pivotal role in making the governments accountable to the public through the parliament or through the legislature. Why I'm saying is that the fiscal discipline is the need of the hour. The most of the allegations or the most of the controversies which are being coming in the political scenario is regarding the allegations regarding the fiscal discipline. And you know, in Kerala, the everyday controversies which we are going on, and throughout the country also, if you examine during the last UPA 2's time also, almost all the controversies on the basis of the fiscal irregularities which is being made by the governments at the time. And all these things are brought out by or through the auditing system or the accounting system. So the scrutiny of the accounts of the government, whether it is government or other private entrepreneurs or corporates, whatever it may be, the chartered accountants are playing a very important role in making the government, making the establishments accountable to the people at large, or accountable to the shareholders, or accountable to the members of the corporate bodies. So in such a situation, now, especially after liberalization, that is means after 1990s, that is during the last 30 years of our experience, when this corporate governance has become part and parcel of the administration, not only in the corporate sector, even in the governmental sector also, we have seen that the corporate form of governance is being adopted almost in all sectors. In such a scenario, in a post-liberalized era, I think that accountants, because the closest scrutiny of all the accounts and its auditing, and it is giving a report and making the erroneous aspects or making all these erroneous aspects into a, in a corrective way. And definitely it is playing a very important or a significant unique role is being played by the chartered accountants in India. So I would like to say that the fiscal discipline has to be maintained. And after all, you know that in the modern era, especially in the information technology and the communication technologies being the spontaneous explosion of development of the IT information technology and communication technology, auditing, accounting in a perfect way is highly required, or it is highly essential, for which we are all depending on the chartered accountants or the accountants, the auditing, it is highly essential and it is required. So the discipline can be fiscal discipline of a corporate body, fiscal discipline of a government, or whichever be the organization, he is depending on accounting and auditing to do this. We are making them accountable. See, we know Controller and Auditor General of India's report, every time it is becoming a controversy. We know the 2G spectrum, 3G spectrum, gold scam, Commonwealth Games, and now in Kerala, every day the media is reporting regarding the CNBJ report. Everything is because accounting and auditing, through which whether the government, whether the corporates, whether the bodies are being maintaining the rules and regulations and fiscal correctness is being made. All these things are being well maintained only because of the auditing and accounting. So in such a situation, and furthermore, now we are living in the era and the government of India always when the PM is speaking, just now Mr. Ahuja, the eloquent speaker just before me has spoke about the Honorable Prime Minister also. They're always talking about the ease of doing business. So ease of doing business is one of the important mantra of the government at the center. See, when we talk about the ease of doing business, we are having the insolvency and bankruptcy code. So many new fiscal legislations are being brought out by the parliament, especially the 16th Lok Sabha during the time of the finance minister, Sri Arun Jaitley. He has made wonderful, drastic, fundamental changes in the fiscal legislations and thereby trying our level best to achieve the goal of ease of doing business. There also, definitely, the role of the chartered accountants is highly, very, very important. Why? Because even it is very difficult to understand the terms and conditions of these codes, of these legislations, it is very difficult without the help or without the assistance of the chartered accountants or the accountants in general. And regarding the Income Tax Act, and so many fiscal legislations, day-to-day changes are coming, amendments to amendments, number of series of amendments are coming for the purpose of ease of doing business. They're all, I think that the accountants have to be well updated, and they should have the current latest knowledge about the fiscal legislations and various aspects regarding the fiscal matters in the country, for which also I think that these types of seminars, these types of conference by which enlightening the accountants and updating the accountants is also the need of the hour. Definitely, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, a statutory body created by an act of parliament in the year 1949, and now having 3 lakh members throughout the country. It's a big community in India. It is a significant community in India. The inevitable part of the accountancy or accountants in India is highly, highly, very, very important in such a situation. Definitely, the updating of the knowledge, the updating of the fiscal legislations, and it's in and out, all these things have to be brought into the mind of the accountants. Definitely, I hope that this 9 days conference, which has started from 16 November and it is being concluded, it is concluding just today. And I think that the conference highlighting the updates of all these issues regarding the accounting and auditing, and the latest legislation have already been discussed, and the lacunas and the defects and so many other practicable disabilities practical difficulties faced by the accountants, especially those who are chartered accountants, all these issues were discussed in depth. I think that the conference was a very, very fruitful conference. Once again, I would like to express my sincere thanks, and I think that I am honored by having inviting for me to this auspicious occasion of the valedictory function of the 9 days conference of the Navaratna conference, organized by the 9 branches of Kerala, which comes under the Southern India Regional Council, and the eminent leaders like Sri Chartered Accountant Babu Abraham Kalivayalil. He is one of the closest family friend of mine, and with his auspicious guidance and leadership for having such a wonderful conference. And I am also getting an opportunity to address you all. Once again, I express my sincere thanks and gratitude to all the delegates and office bearers of the ICA and this conference the organizing committee of this conference. And with your all permission and with best wishes, I would like to declare that the Navaratna conference, that is the Navaratna conference, that the CA conference jointly organized by the 9 branches of SIRC of ICA in Kerala, is being concluded, and it is the valedictory conference of this session being inaugurated. In these ways, let me conclude my speech. And once again, I'm sorry that I couldn't take part in a better platform so as to address in a better way. Really, I'm sorry for it. And once again, I'm wishing you all the best. And definitely, I will always be with you regarding, especially in the legislation, if you are having anything regarding the legislation, the fiscal legislation, so the matters regarding the accountants in India, definitely you can very well approach me, and you can very well approach me, and I will do the best of my knowledge and my ability within the parliament and outside the parliament. In these words, I conclude. Once again, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, N.K. Premachandra ji, for a wonderful thought-provoking address. I think we are in fact really honored and proud to have you with us. You made a very excellent speech, and I think no wonder you have been adjudged as the best parliamentarian, and no wonder this is your fourth term in the parliament. And despite serving in various forums, including as a minister in the state, I am sure